Hello everyone, now let us discuss about part 3 of anti-arithmetrics. And in the current session, we will be focusing on the class 3 of anti-arrhythmic drugs. Now, coming to class 3 anti-arrhythmic drugs, the special feature of class 3 anti-arrhythmic drugs is that they prolong the cardiac action potential. This is an important point. The special feature of class 3 antiarrhythmic drugs is that they prolong the cardiac action potential. And the complete mechanism of this effect is not fully understood, but to an extent it is contributed by blocking some of the potassium channels. So, on a broader context, the class 3 drugs are potassium channel blockers. So, by blocking some of the potassium channels involved in the cardiac repolarization, including the outward rectifier potassium channels or delayed rectifier potassium channels, these class 3 antiarrhythmics, they prolong the action potential. And the characteristic action of this class is the prolongation of repolarization or phase 3. Now coming to the general risks of class 3 drugs, since they prolong the action potential, they have proarrhythmic effects. And notably, a polymorphic form of ventricular tachycardia, that is nothing but torsades de pointis. And this effect may be due to increased dispersion of repolarization, that is lack of spatial homogeneity. And this leads to increased calcium entry during the prolonged action potential. And this increases after depolarizations, which may lead to arrhythmic effects, proarrhythmic effects. So this, that is the consequence of occurring of torsades de pointis, it occurs particularly in the patients that are taking other drugs that can prolong the QT interval, such as antipsychotic drugs, and patients with disturbances in electrolytes involved in repolarization, that is either who are suffering from hypokalemia or hypercalcemia, and the individuals with hereditarily prolonged QT interval, which is nothing but Ward-Romano syndrome. So these are the general risk factors who are prone, particularly in case of patients who are prone to torsades de pointis by taking class 3 antiarrhythmic drugs. Now coming to the overall mechanism of action of class 3 antiarrhythmic drugs, as we have discussed earlier, their principal action is prolongation of repolarization phase, that is nothing but phase 3. And this leads to prolongation of action potential, and this in turn leads to the increase in the effective refractive period, EPR. That is nothing but the tissue remains refractory even after it is fully repolarized. So increased EPR, effective refractive period, is the main effect by which the reentrant tachycardias and ectopic pacemaker activity are suppressed. So this is the major anti-arrhythmic action that the class 3 drugs result. Now coming to the examples of class 3 anti-arrhythmic drugs, in the current session we will be discussing about 5 drugs. The first one is amiodarone, second one is dronedarone, next is sotalol and dofetilide and ibutilide. Now first coming to amiodarone. Amiodarone is an iodine containing highly lipophilic long-acting antiarrhythmic drug that can exert multiple actions. That it does not only have class 3 action, but it also has class 1, 2, 3 and 4 actions. They are, the first one is prolongation of action potential duration and QT interval. By prolonging the action potential duration and QT interval, it reduces the non-uniformity of refractiveness. And this occurs as it blocks the outward rectifier potassium channels. The next action is, it blocks the inactivated sodium channels with rapid rate of channel recovery. And because of this, depression of conduction occurs in the cells that are partially depolarized or have longer action potential duration. The next action is, it partially inhibits the myocardial calcium channels. and additionally it has non-competitive beta adrenergic blocking property, and it also alters the thyroid function. These are the various effects of amiodarone. And the conduction is slowed and the ectopic automaticity are mildly depressed. But the SA node automaticity is slightly affected. One more important point is the effect of oral dose on cardiac contractility and BP are minimal. But IV injection frequently causes myocardial depression and hypotension. One more important point is the risk of torsades de bointes is low for amiodarone. Though it prolongs the QT interval, the risk is low. The prolongation of action potential duration by other drugs of class 3 is more marked at slower rates of activation, which encourages the early after depolarizations than at higher rates. Other drugs, they show what is the reason of low risk is the prolongation of APD by other drugs of class 3 is more marked at slower rates of activation than at higher rates. While the amiodarone is independent of rate of activation because of its multiple effects, that is it has class 1, class 2, class 3 and class 4 effect, and also because it is independent of rate of activation, the risk of torsades de bointes is low for amiodarone. The amiodarone is incompletely and slowly absorbed from the GNT. It is extensively bound to tissues and has large volume of distribution and longer elimination half-life of 10 to 100 days, and it accumulates in the body during repeated dosing. For this reason, a loading dose is used. And for life-threatening arrhythmias, it is given intravenously via a central vein, as it causes phlebitis if given into a peripheral vessel. This is an important point. For life-threatening arrhythmias, amiodarone is given intravenously via a central vein, as it causes phlebitis if it is given into a peripheral vessel. And amiodarone is mainly metabolized in liver by CYP3A4, and one of its metabolites is Aptiq. Coming to the uses, amiodarone is mainly used in resistant ventricular tachycardias and recurrent ventricular fibrillations. These two are the most important indications. It is effective in ventricular and supraventricular arrhythmias, including PSVT, nodal and ventricular tachycardias, and atrial fibrillation. It is used to maintain the sinus rhythm in atrial fibrillation when other drugs have failed. One more important point is the rapid termination of ventricular and supraventricular arrhythmias can be obtained by IV injection. And WPW, that is nothing but Wolff Parkinson's Wine Syndrome tachyarrhythmia, is terminated by suppression of both normal and aberrant pathway. And the long duration of action of the amiodarone, it makes it suitable for chronic prophylactic therapy. Longer duration of action of the amiodarone makes it suitable for chronic prophylactic therapy. Coming to the adverse effects, amiodarone has n number of adverse effects, and the dose related adverse effects are falling BP, bradycardia, and myocardial depression. They usually occur on IV injection and after drug accumulation. Other effects such as nausea, gastrointestinal upset may be seen with oral medication, especially during the loading dose. And even hepatitis may occur rarely. One more important adverse effect is photosensitization and sunburn-like skin pigmentation. Slate gray bluish discoloration of skin is seen with amiodarone, and as it affects the thyroid function, thyroid abnormalities such as goiter and hypothyroidism are rare, whereas hyperthyroidism is more common, connected with its iodine content and because of its inhibition of peripheral conversion of T4 to T3. hormone T4 to T3. Another adverse effects is pulmonary fibrosis and alveolitis, which is late in onset but may be reversible. And even peripheral neuropathy can occur, which generally manifests as weakness of shoulder and pelvic muscles. Coming to the drug interactions, the amiodarone can increase the digoxin and warfarin levels by reducing their renal clearance. And additive AV block can occur in patients receiving beta blockers and calcium channel blockers. As it is metabolized by CYP3A4, inducers and inhibitors of CYP3A4 respectively decrease and increase the amiodarone levels. And amiodarone itself, it inhibits CYP3A4 and CYP2C9 and paraglycoprotein in order to interact with other drugs. Coming to the next drug of class 3, that is dronedarone. It is a recently introduced non-iodinated congener of amiodarone. It does not contain iodine and it is a related benzofurone. Dronedarone is a related benzofurone. And when you compare with amiodarone, it is comparatively less lipophilic. The elimination half-life is shorter. It is less toxic and less effective class 3 agent. And it is less indicated in patients with permanent atrial fibrillation due to increased rates of stroke, heart failure, and death. Like amiodarone, dronedarone is a multi-channel blocker. It inhibits delayed outward rectifier and other types of cardiac potassium channels. That is nothing but the class 3 action. It inhibits the inward sodium channel and L-type calcium channel. The non-competitive beta-adrenergic blocking activity is more marked in dronedarone than amiodarone. This is an important point. The non-competitive beta-adrenergic blocking activity is more marked in dronedarone than amiodarone, but it does not interfere with the thyroid function as in case of amiodarone. And it increases the myocardial action potential duration, effective refractive period, and slows the AV conduction. And absorption is doubled whenever it is taken with meal. Absorption of dronedarone is doubled whenever it is taken along with meal. It is metabolized primarily by CYP3A4 and CYP2D6. And the inhibitors of these isoenzymes, for example, ketoconazole, erythromycin, and metoprolol, etc., they markedly increase the blood levels. And the elimination half-life is 24 hours. Coming to the adverse reaction, the gastrointestinal disturbances, bradycardia, weakness, cough, and dermatological reactions are seen. Risk of torsades depointus is low, though it prolongs QT interval. Hypothyroidism, pulmonary fibrosis, and peripheral neuropathy does not occur, as in case of amiodarone. The hypothyroidism, pulmonary fibrosis, and peripheral neuropathy does not occur in case of dronedarone. And it is contraindicated in moderate to severe congestive heart failure, second and third degree AV block, and in case of permanent atrial fibrillation because of high risk of rates of stroke and cardiac death. Coming to the uses, clinical use of dronedarone is limited to supraventricular tachycardias, and primarily it is indicated to maintain the sinus rhythm in hemodynamically stable patients of paroxysmal and non-permanent atrial fibrillation. It is also used to control ventricular rate during the atrial fibrillation. Coming to the next drug, that is sotalol. It is a non-selective beta-adrenergic blocking agent. It has a prominent class 3 action by prolonging the repolarization by blocking cardiac inward rectifier potassium channels. Sotalol exerts its action by blocking the cardiac inward rectifier potassium channels. The inward rectifier potassium channels, they conduct a hyperpolarizing outward potassium current. What is the function of this inward rectifier potassium channel means? these inward rectifier potassium channels, they conduct a hyperpolarizing outward potassium current. And since sotalol blocks the inward rectifier potassium channels, it delays the slow outward potassium current. It delays the slow outward potassium current and leads to prolongation of cardiac action potential and QT interval. It is a racemic mixture with D isomer, has pure class 3 activity, and whereas the L isomer is a beta blocker and also has class 3 activity. The D isomer has only class 3 activity, whereas the L isomer has beta blocking activity and class 3 activity. It is generally given as a racemic mixture. And it is not a sodium channel blocker and does not depress the conduction in fast response tissue. But it delays AV conduction and prolongs effective refractive period. Coming to the uses, sotalol is mainly used to treat paroxysmal supraventricular dysrhythmias, to suppress ventricular ectopic beats, short runs of ventricular tachycardia. And it is clinically used in patients in whom beta adrenoreceptor antagonists are not contraindicated. And it is contraindicated in patients with long QT interval. The risk factors are, it may cause torsados depointus, and close monitoring of potassium levels is essential during the therapy. Coming to the next drug, dofetilide. It is a new antiarrhythmic which prolongs the action potential duration and effective refractive period by selectively blocking rapid component of delayed rectifier current. Dofetilide, it selectively blocks the rapid component of delayed rectifier current without affecting other channels and receptors. It has no autonomic or peripheral actions, so it is termed as pure class 3 antiarrhythmic. So the example of pure class 3 antiarrhythmic is dofetilide, and it is mainly excreted unchanged in urine and produces fewer side effects. It is contraindicated in the presence of hypokalemia and bradycardia, and it has a risk of torsados depointus. Coming to the uses, it can convert atrial fibrillation to sinus rhythm, but more effective in maintaining the sinus rhythm in the converted patients. It can convert, but it is more effective in maintaining the sinus rhythm in converted patients. And the chronic therapy does not increase the mortality rate in patients with high-risk sudden cardiac death or post-myocardial infarction. Coming to the next drug, that is ibutilide. It is a new antiarrhythmic drug which blocks rapid inward rectifier current. This ibutilide, it blocks rapid inward rectifier current. Coming to the uses, the IV injection for conversion of atrial fibrillation to sinus rhythm. And the patients who respond generally convert within 20 to 30 minutes of the injection. The efficacy is higher in reset onset cases and in AFI when compared to AF. The risk factor is induction of torsados depointus is a risk. By this, we complete the class 3 antiarrhythmic drugs. Thank you for watching.